Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Brady, and in this video, I'll be showing and commentating on some of my footage from my open water scuba certification course, in which I got to dive the beautiful waters of Vortex Spring in Florida. Here in this clip, we have two divers from my class working on their underwater navigation training. And right here, they're working on trying to reach and maintain a desired depth and maintain neutral buoyancy. One of the most difficult aspects for beginner scuba divers is remaining at your desired depth. It can be kind of difficult at first, and it takes a little bit of getting used to, but it is a crucial part of scuba diving. Now directly below these divers is the famous Vortex Spring underwater cave. This cave was too dangerous for us. We were just working on open water scuba. We were not qualified to do any cave diving, and there have reportedly been some deaths in this cave. So we definitely weren't going to go anywhere near this cave, definitely not going inside. But it was very cool to see from the surface. Now for our final test of our scuba training, we explored this old boat wreck at the bottom of the spring. And this area was absolutely filled with all of these curious bluegill. Old wrecks and structures act as artificial reefs, attracting all sorts of fish to areas just like this. The ship is covered in algae, and that's going to bring in smaller fish feeding on the algae, and those smaller fish are going to bring in even larger fish to prey on those smaller fish species. So areas like this are absolutely perfect for getting up close with some beautiful aquatic wildlife. Now in this area with all of these bluegill, I was hoping to see a largemouth bass, but unfortunately we did not see any right here. Hopefully on this dive, I'll get to see one. And this was an absolutely amazing experience, getting to interact with all of these beautiful fish species in their natural environment. As a fisherman, you take the fish out of its environment and get it up close to you, but it's a whole other experience getting in their environment and moving in close to the fish and having them actually come up and want to get a closer look at you. They were absolutely inquisitive, swimming around us at all times, and it was just an amazing experience. And after we completed this final bottom dive, we were officially dive certified. With our certification complete and some extra air in our tanks, my dive buddies and I decided to continue exploring the spring. Now, fishing in freshwater environments for most of my life, I knew that grass beds and thick reeds would be an excellent spot to find some fish. It wasn't long before we were surrounded by curious fish maneuvering through the vegetation. Then, out of the dense green reeds, emerged my target species, the largemouth bass. I grew up catching largemouth bass. They're my favorite freshwater fish to catch, so getting to encounter them in their natural habitat was amazing. I was so thrilled to get up close with my favorite freshwater fish. As we continue to explore this grassy environment, we can see another largemouth bass as he camouflages perfectly with the green vegetation, probably cruising the area in search of some bluegill that he can snatch up. And here this largemouth comes in for a close-up. Now, as I begin checking out this new bit of structure, my dive buddies mistakenly stir up some of the vegetation with their fins, stirring up a lot of the grass and a lot of the sediment on the bottom of the spring. Now, this debris will eventually settle, but it's important for all divers to be aware of their surroundings so as to avoid disturbing these beautiful ecosystems. And out of the destruction swims this little musk turtle, seeking refuge in some undisturbed reeds. Here you can see him hiding from me, getting below the grass. The little musk turtle peeks his head out of his hiding place to make sure the area is free of danger. I absolutely love turtles, so getting up close with this guy on my first real dive was an incredibly lucky experience. Now it's time to leave him alone so he can go about the rest of his day. See ya, buddy. Through hand signals, my dive buddies and I decide to check out another shipwreck with our last bit of air before surfacing. I give them the okay sign, and we're on our way. This second boat wreck was massive and closer to the surface, allowing more light penetration through the water and giving the water this beautiful blue hue. Just like the first wreck, this structure is great for attracting fish, with plenty of largemouth bass patrolling the area in search of prey. Unfortunately, we did not have enough air or time left to explore the rest of the wreckage. After checking our gauges, we took one final look around the area before making our ascent back to the surface. My time getting open water scuba certified at Vortex Spring was amazing. Everybody was great, and seeing all of the spring's wildlife was incredible. Truly an unforgettable experience. If you're looking to get dive certified in the Biloxi, Mississippi area, Adventure Locators is the place to go. Maybe the next dive I'll be exploring a coral reef or ocean shipwreck. Wherever my next adventure takes me, I can't wait to get back in the water for another look into the underwater world.